Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 6.7 in the module Inventory Model. The topic for the discussion is Inventory Management Techniques, the solution for solution and program problem solving. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the economic ordering quantity, explain the inventory management techniques. So in the inventory management, the first parameter that we discussed earlier, lead time. So the time interval between the placement of an order and receipt of the good into the stock is the lead time. The lead time is a stochastic variable. So the lead time consists of three elements. So one is pre-processing lead time. So it is also known as planning time or paperwork. The pre-processing lead time is the time required to release the purchase order. So if you are buying certain item from your vendor, it is the time to release the purchase order, preparing the letter and sending it to the vendor. And suppose you are a manufacturer, it is a time required to create a job. Then from the time you learn that there is a requirement. So if you are in your factory or in your business, there is some requirement of certain item. You are placing order. So after finding the requirement, you are placing the order. So the time gap between the release of purchase order and the learning of your requirement, it is called as pre-processing lead time. Processing lead time is the time required to procure or manufacture an item. So after placing the order, you have to purchase the item. That is the processing lead time. Then post-processing lead time, the time to make the purchased item. So the item is reached, item has reached your factory or industry, and it should be made available in the inventory. So the time required to make the purchased item available in the inventory from the time you receive it. So including quarantine time, inspection time, etc. So that is what post-processing lead time. So pre-processing lead time, processing lead time, and the post-processing lead time. These are the three elements of the lead time. Then the reorder level, another parameter that you have to understand is the reorder level. The reorder level is the stock level at which the fresh order is placed with the supplier for economic ordering quantity, EOQ. So EOQ is the economic ordering quantity or the optimum quantity that we have to purchase. So we discussed various inventory problem in the earlier lectures to calculate the economic ordering quantity or optimum quantity, that is what the EOQ. So reorder level equal to lead time demand plus safety stock. So where lead time demand equal to lead time, the total time for the purchase of item and make it available in the inventory system, that is what the lead time, and into multiplied by average demand, that is the lead time demand. Then the safety stock is calculated by the extra stock in excess of the lead time demand is called as safety stock or the buffer stock. Suppose due to unforeseen situation, there is extension of the lead time, there is delay in the receipt of the goods into the factory, for that to make the business to run, we require some safety stock. That is what the safety stock or the buffer stock. So safety stock is calculated by maximum lead time minus normal lead time into average demand. Or there is another formula, safety stock equal to Z into SD. So Z is the service factor or the safety factor, and SD is the standard deviation. And the service factor or the safety factor is taken from the table. So this is the table which is available in the standard textbooks for taking your service factor. So depending on the service level, you can take the service factor. So for example, if it is 100%, the service factor is 3.72. If it is 80%, the service factor is 0.84. Now we take examples to understand the concept of reorder level and the lead time. Example number 20, a company uses annually 50,000 units of an item each costing rupees 1.2. Each order cost 45 rupees, and the inventory carrying cost is 15% of the average annual inventory value. Find the economic ordering quantity. If the company operates 250 days in a year, the procurement time is 10 days, the safety stock is 500 units. Find the reorder level, maximum, minimum inventory and average inventory. So, the data given in the problem, demand rate R equal to 50,000, the cost of each item is rupees 1.2, setup cost C3 equal to rupees 45 and holding cost is 15%, 0.15 into 1.2 equal to rupees 0.18. Then economic ordering quantity for the model EOQ equal to square root of 2C3R divided by C1, which is square root of 2 into 45 into 50,000 divided by 0.18 equal to 5,000 items. Then reorder level equal to safety stock plus consumption during the lead time. So, safety stock is given in the problem as 500 and the number of days of the lead time is 10 days. So, 10 into 50,000 divided by 250 days we are working. So, 10 into 50,000 divided by 250 that equal to 2500 items. So, reorder level is 2500 items. That means, when the stock level reaches 2500 items, you have to place the order for the new purchase. Now, the maximum inventory equal to EOQ plus safety stock. So, 5000 plus 2500 equal to 7500 item. Minimum inventory level equal to the safety stock, which is 2500 items. Average inventory is 7500 plus 2500 divided by 2 equal to 5000 items. So, these are all the answers to the problem. We take another example, example number 21. The lead time demand distribution of an item can be approximated by a normal distribution with a mean of 250 and standard deviation 5. At what level should the reorder point is set so that there will be less than 7% chance of a stock out? What will be the safety stock at this level? So, we are given a lead time demand is 250 and the standard deviation is 5 and the percentage of service required. So, you look at the problem, what level should the reorder point set so that there will be less than 7% chance of stock out. So, the service required 100 minus 7 equal to 93%. So, 93% of the time we require the service. So, sometimes we may have the stock out for 5-7% chance. So, the safety stock from the table for 93% service, the Z equal to safety factor from the table for 93% service equal to 1.48 and the safety stock equal to Z into 1.48. So, 1.4 Z into SD. So, 1.48 into 5 equal to 7.4. So, reorder level equal to safety stock plus lead time demand. So, 7.4 plus 250 equal to 257.4. So, then we discuss the inventory management techniques. So, the inventory management, or material management that refers to the process of ordering, storing and using a company's inventory. That is what inventory management. This includes the management of raw material, components and the finished product and as well as warehousing and processing such item. So, the inventory may be a raw material, the finished component, semi-finished component or the material in process. So, as well as warehousing. So, the material management also including maintaining or processing the item in the warehouse and maintaining the warehouse. That is what the inventory management. There are different techniques available for inventory management. The very popular method is ABC analysis, HML analysis, VED analysis, FSN analysis, LIFO, that is last in, last out, FIFO, that is first in, first out, and the latest technique, very popular technique is just in time, JIT. So, we discuss few of the inventory management techniques in the further in the lecture. First, we take the ABC analysis. So, ABC analysis is inventory management technique that determines the value of the inventory items based on their importance to the business. So, ABC ranks the item on demand, cost and risk data. So, ABC three category of item based on the demand for the item, cost of the item and risk data and the inventory managers groups the item into classes based on the criteria. So based on three criteria, we are grouping, the inventory managers group the item into category A, B or C. So the procedure for ABC analysis, suppose you have a huge factory, we have to group the item into A and B, A, B and C. What is the procedure? The procedure is identify all the items used in the industry. So list out all the items in the industry. So the material, raw material, finished product, everything we have to identify. List all the items as per the value. So cost of the item. So the, that you have to note it down. So value means cost of the item. Count the number of high valued, medium valued and low valued. So now group the item based on the high value, medium value and the low value. So find the percentage of high value, medium value and low valued items. High valued items normally contribute 70% of the total inventory cost, and the medium and low valued items cost, it contributes 20% and 10% respectively. A graph is plotted between the percentage of item in x-axis and the percentage of total inventory cost in the y-axis. So the graph I will show in the next slide. So this is what the ABC category. So class A, class B and class C, the importance. Class A, that means high cost items. So in the percentage of total inventory, it is only 10% of total inventory. Annual consumption cost, with respect to cost, so it is 70% to 80% of the total inventory cost. So it should have tight control. We have to control it tightly. So we have to effectively monitor the inventory of the system. So we require high accurate record for class A item. Class B, it is medium cost items. So it contribute 15% to 20% of inventory, as well as it takes 15% to 20% of the inventory cost. So we require some medium control and good record keeping. Good records are required for the class B item. So class C, it is low cost items. The total item, number of item will be 70% and the cost of the cost in the inventory management is 10% to 15%. We require only the basic control, a minimum record is enough. So the ABC analysis furnishes the following information. Item A item are high valued but are limited or few in number. So they need careful and close inventory control. So that is what we said, tight control. A detailed record of the receipt issue should be kept and the proper handling and storage facility should be provided for them. So we have to be very, very careful on the A type of item because it is costly. We have to be very careful. A item generally accounts 70% to 80% total inventory cost and they contribute about 10% of the total item. Then such item being costly or purchased in small quantity, often we can frequently purchase, but you have to purchase in small quantity and just before their use. This may increase the procurement cost because we are making more number of purchases, so it may increase the procurement cost, but the inventory cost decreases and the problem of storage and the caretaking minimized. So nothing wrong. So instead of purchasing in a huge number and keeping in the inventory for a longer time, dumping the money, so we can purchase in smaller quantity and we can frequently make order for the class A item. Class B items are medium value and the number lies between A and the C items. Such item need moderate control. They are purchased on the basis of the past requirement. So based on the previous record, we can purchase the item. A record of receipt and the issue is kept and the procurement order is placed as soon as the quantity touches the reorder point. So it requires medium control. When the reorder point reaches, you have to immediately place the order. B item being comparatively less costly and the safety stock up to 3 months maybe we can keep. So it may be kept for 3 months stock. B item generally accounts for 20 to 15% of total inventory cost and constitute about 10 to 20% of the total item. So the percentage of item is 10 to 20 and cost is 20 to 15%. Then item C item are low valued but the maximum numbered item. So these items do not need any control. Rather, controlling them is costly. So the process of monitoring will become costly. So does not require any control. So these are least important items like clips, all kinds of pins, washers, rubber band, etc. So these are all the very, very cheap items used in the factory. No expediting is necessary. No record is normally kept, and the safety stock for 3 months or even more than more can be purchased at any instant. So C item generally accounts for 10 to 15% of the total inventory cost, and they constitute 75% of the total item. So this is what ABC, and this is the ABC graph. So the graph how we track the cumulative percentage of item and cumulative percentage of annual usage value, that is cost. So item A constitute 20% item, but 70% of the cost. Item B 20% of the average 20% of the item and 10% of the cost. Then item C, it look at here 60% or 60% of the stock, and the cost is only 20%. So based on the data. And the VAD analysis. So they are the items, again the procedure going to be the same. We have to group the item, we have to take the list, and based on the list we have to note it down in terms of vital item, essential item and desirable item. So based on the vital item, essential item, desirable item, we have to classify and keep in maintain the stock and maintain the stock based on the value. And the FSN, fast moving item, slow moving item and non moving item. So these are all the some of the inventory management technique for different factories or business enterprises. And finally, just in time management. So just in time manufacturing, just in time manufacturing originated in Japan in 1960s and 70s. Toyota Motor contributed the most to its development. The method allows companies to save significant amount of money and reduces the waste by keeping only the inventory they needed to produce and sell the product. So this approach reduces the storage and the insurance cost, as well as the cost of liquidating or discarding excess inventory. So just in inventory management also risky. So because we are significant saving the money. So we place order as and when it is required. So the that is what the just in time inventory management technique. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Operation Research. You can refer to the book for additional information. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You refer to the YouTube channel, subscribe the channel for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification for the inventory management subject. So we will meet again in another video lecture in the Operation Research. Until then, bye.